Sorry guys, trying to get adjusted. Excuse me. All right, so I'm trying to sneak and do a live really quickly. This is the earliest that I could do today. My baby is finally sleeping. So I have these flowers that I bought from the Dollar Tree that I just used for a wreath that I just made. You guys can check out my channel. Check out that video if you want to check it out. And I had these flowers left over. And I was sitting here like, what should I draw? And I said, let's sketch from these flowers. So, that's basically what we're going to do today. So I'm just kind of trying to place some in an angle. I'm gonna sharpen my pencil. Talk to me, guys, who's out there watching. Alright, so I just prompt them in a container, and I'm just going to go ahead and sketch what I see. I'm trying to get like a good angle I could draw from. This is too tall. Probably should have had these sketched out already. Let me clip this. That's fine. So I'm looking at, excuse my desk, guys, those flowers there, and I'm going to sketch that. So I'm just kind of looking at the shape, laying down some shapes, and then from there I'll start filling in petals and whatnot. And I don't want to make this too technical. Like, I just kind of want to, like, loosely. Draw these in. So the best way, the best reference to use sometimes is from life. The best way to practice drawing, learn drawing, is drawing from life. And even though these are some fake flowers, they still will do as a really good reference. Especially the way the light's hitting it, because I can see my shadows and all that. And then there's one little one here, and a bigger one there. This one's kind of folded. So I'm just praying that my son doesn't get up while I'm streaming so I can get this, a good part of this done. All right, I like that. So moving on. And this one's closest to me, so it's going to be bigger. The ones that are further back are going to be smaller to show that they're in the background. So again, I'm just going to kind of sketch in the shape, kind of just sketching those shapes that I see. So I see I got a couple viewers. It's not saying exactly who, but thank you guys for joining in. Feel free to chat with me. Just sketching some flowers. And we're going to go ahead and paint these in watercolor. I love it when the petals fold. Like, it just looks so pretty to me. My kids are blasting that music. Oh my goodness. I mean the TV, they're blasting it. Let me know if you guys can hear it in the background. Alright. So there's that one. One second, guys. Sorry about that, guys. All right, and then we got one more in the back. And this is kind of a hard angle to draw from, because really this is kind of blocking the view for this one. So I'm just gonna add in some petals that I see sticking out from my perspective. All right. There's a stem here. You can see a leaf here. And again, I don't want to make this really perfect. I want this to be really loose, because I can add in details later. Okay, there's another leaf. There's a stem. All right. So I'm going to be using my trusty, convenient Jane Davenport palette in the neutral set. Let's see if I can zoom out a little. Should have had everything ready, guys. I'm sorry. I'm gonna go ahead and clean this palette. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a puddle of water in here. And as you can see, the flowers are like a yellow peach color. So I'm going to start with a light layer. I'm going to add a touch of yellow to that. Maybe two yellow. I'm just gonna go ahead and do a wash over all those petals. I'm going to let that dry some. As that's drying, I'm going to go ahead and mix a color for my stem and leaves. So I actually have a little pan of some Daniel Smith watercolors. And this color is Undersea Green. And I think I'm going to use that. Probably add a little bit of yellow to that. Because it's such a dark, like almost olivey green. So I'm going to add a little bit of that yellow. And I'm just going to go ahead and add that to the leaves. Light wash. And I want to be careful not to go too close to the wet flower petals because it'll bleed into the flower and I don't want that. Alright, so while those petals are still a little damp, I'm going to go back into that color that we mixed previously. And I'm actually running, the color's almost gone, so I'm going to go ahead and mix some more. But I'm going to make it stronger this time using more pigment. I'm going to add a little bit of this red color. This is the color that it's giving me. I'm just going to kind of play with it so I get the color that I want. I feel like that's too bright. So I'm going to tone it down with a little more of that color. Gonna add a little of the yellow. Tad bit more red. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and add this. And again, I'm using my flowers in front of me as a reference. So I'm just going to kind of place it in there where it's a little wet and let it do its thing. It's kind of drying up on me. And there's a ton of water here, so I'm going to kind of mop some of that up. Now I'm going to do the same thing with the leaves. I'm going to make it a little bit more pigmented. I'm gonna add a little bit of blue. I'm gonna actually add a little bit of red to that. And that's the tips. Cause on the leaves of these, there's like some reddish color there. Go ahead and hit this with the blow dryer hair so we don't have to wait so long. So I'm going back in with that reddish color, and I'm just going to go ahead and bring it back to that green, adding more of that undersea green and that yellow. So I'm going back into that peach color here, and I'm adding a little bit of blue to get like a shadow color. And I'm looking at my reference, and I'm just kind of laying down where my shadows are. Guys, don't forget, when you're doing watercolor, it always dries a little lighter. Guys, feel free to join me in painting. So I'm going back to that peach color, and I'm deepening it with some more red and yellow. Again, looking at my reference, laying in those colors, those spots. Guys, I'm just mixing and trying to remix this color that I made. And I'm just going to go ahead and I'm using a clean brush. Damp clean brush. And I'm just going to go ahead and blend out those harsh edges. So I'm gonna go ahead and move on to this flower. Let me start with the darker, the bright spots. There's like so many petals, so it's kind of hard to differentiate. But I just want to show you guys some exercises you guys can do. To help you guys with drawing, watercolor, study of value, whatever. Anything that's, anytime you're drawing or painting or whatever. You're perfecting your craft, you're getting better and better. So there's like kind of folds on here. I'm gonna try to replicate that texture on this leaf. I'm gonna go ahead and blend out some of these harsh lines. Again, using a clean out my brush and patting it dry. So it's still a little damp on the cloth. So I want to add a darker shadow here, but I'm going to let that dry first. I'm going to go ahead and add the stems here, and they're going to be like a really dark green. So I'm going in with that Undersea Green by Daniel Smith. Add some blue to darken it up. And a touch of red. Still not dark enough. I'm gonna let that dry. I'm actually gonna blend out these parts that are dry. I'm And once again, the way that I'm blending it out is cleaning out my brush, wiping off some of the excess water, and just using the damp brush to blend out those harsh lines. Alright, it's dry there, so I can go ahead and add my shadow in this spot around here. I want to bring back some of that red in these leaves. trying to see if I want to add a background to this. Try not to run this along anywhere where it's wet because it's going to bleed into the rest of the picture and I don't want that. Excuse me, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and dry this with my blow dryer. See, this is what I didn't want to happen right here. I got too close to where it was wet. So I'm just going to clean my brush out, pat it dry on my sponge, and just mop that up. gonna go ahead and soften this. Alright guys, so that's it. I think I'm done. Let me go ahead and find a pen to sign this. Can never find my pen when I need it. May 8, 2017. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for joining me. Comment below what you think, how it came out. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.